In the book of Genesis, chapter 3, we find that it is one of the saddest chapters in the Bible, because it talks to us about the most difficult moment for mankind, and that is when Adam and Eve were disobedient to God's mandate, and they were deceived by Satan. And Satan, he inflated their ego, and they got filled with pride, and in their mind they came to think that they could actually become like God. And so they fell into the enemy's trap, they took the bait, and from being authorities as God had created them to be, God had placed them as kings over all the earth. There was no one that had more authority than that first couple in the face of this universe. But when they were deceived and when they sinned, they lost practically everything. And God, as a loving father, he had left them in the Garden of Eden, but he didn't find them when he looked for them. And the Lord himself, he had to ask, and he had to say, Adam, where were you? And that is found in chapter 3 and verse 9. The Lord, he said, when he asked him, where were you? It's because when God created man, he made him a spirit, a soul, and a body. And what was most predominant in the first couple was that spiritual part. We could say that men were more of a spirit that had a body, not so much a body that had a soul. But when man sinned, immediately God didn't find his spirit anywhere in the garden. And so he is asking Adam, where were you? And so Adam, he answered, and he said, Lord, I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked. And what happened in this couple that broke God's divine principles, that were distanced from what God had commanded, and they sinned. And when Adam told the Lord, I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, he was aware that he had done something that was not right. And that is when the Lord, he asked him a second question, and it is found in verse 11, and he said, and who told you, or who taught you that you were naked? In other words, who was your teacher? Who taught you that? Who did you open your ears to allow a different doctrine to the one that I gave you? And if there is something that we must really guard in a very good way, is our doctrine, the doctrine that we received. Today, there are many preachers out there, there are many teachers, but the Lord, he taught us that we are to discern between one and another. The main doctrine is found in this book, in the Bible. And though today there are people wanting to bring changes to the world because of humanism, as accepting agnostics as though they were redeemers who had a greater heart than God, and that man could become as important without God, and to say that we don't need God, they are on the wrong path. When Adam, when he wanted to think that he could become like God just by allowing the thought in his mind, that took him out of God's divine purpose. And God said to him, who taught you that? I didn't teach you that. Who did you open your ear to? And it's very important to know what people are teaching you, or what people are teaching your children. This is a very difficult time that we are living in, where children, without parents even realizing, they could get on the internet and they could receive wrongful formation where parents many times don't even notice. And I suggest, parents, that you be aware of your children's activity and do not allow someone with agnostic ideas and skeptic ideas, or even demonic ideas, come and be the ones who pastor your children, because they will take them out of your home and then they're going to destroy them. So you must really guard the information that you and your children are receiving and be very careful of the media that is informing them. And the third question that the Lord said to this first couple was, what have you done? That is found in verse 13, like saying, look at the consequences of taking a wrong step. When someone commits a sin, they go astray from God's divine purpose. The message of the Lord said was, look at the consequences. What is this that you have done? This is all happening because of your sin. Adam's sin brought curse to all of his descendants. The Apostle Paul, when he preached in Athens, he said, and from one blood he made all the lineage of man. In other words, that contaminated blood of Adam corrupted all of humankind until Christ came to redeem us from that curse, and he gave us a new lineage. Remember those three questions. Where were you? Who taught you? And what is this that you have done? May the Lord bless you.